You have two educational institutions based at the Aga Khan Centre, and a lot of the research and educational programmes are about understanding Muslim cultures. The gardens become a way of sharing ideas connected with Muslim culture with a much broader audience. So they're a really great bridge builder between ourselves and the public. And so we arrange and have tours at least twice a week. We open for open gardens. The six gardens at the Aga Khan Centre, which we call the Islamic Gardens at King's Cross, they're inspired by different parts of the Muslim world. So you'll have gardens inspired by southern Spain or North Africa, gardens inspired by South and Central Asia, or a Middle Eastern loggia. And sometimes these will just be outdoor rooms. Gardens in Muslim cultures can be all sorts of things. Yes, plants are very important, but so too is somewhere to sit. There'll often be a water feature. Water is a kind of essential as one of the main sources for natural life. Parts of the Muslim world are very hot, and so you will often find that the design will play a lot with light and shadow. One of my favourite gardens, the Garden of Light, has this sort of ribbon of marble all the way around it. And the Persian calligraphy is all poetry. The main inspiration was poetry that spoke either about the natural world or about education and knowledge and seeking knowledge. We have a lot of students from different parts of the world, and the gardens are open to anybody using the building.
This is the place I enjoyed the most, because this gives me a study break when I come here. And what we do sometimes with my classmates, we come here, enjoy the sunset, enjoy a chat.
I love the Garden of Life because there are just so many plants, and that was designed by Madison Cox with a view to it being a sharing garden. Like, so he's planted mainly fruit and nut trees. And so we've got our own little Mughal-inspired garden here in London. I don't have a garden at home. I have always lived in the city, and you don't always associate coming to work and having a garden. And here I don't just have one garden, we have six gardens to choose from. So it's just a huge privilege.